Hi, kindergarten. We're going to be talking about Thanksgiving now and Thanksgiving long ago. And one of the ways we're going to do it is by comparing what life was like for children now. Excuse me, I should say what life was like for children then and what life is like for children now. And we're going to do something called compare and contrast. That means we're going to show how things are like and different. And we're going to use this big chart here to help us with that. Now, the fancy name for this big chart is called a Venn diagram. It's not that important that you know what it's called, but it is important that you understand how it helps us compare things. Do you see my two circles here? Kind of reminds you of this circle here and maybe this circle here, right? When they're separate. So the way we like to think about it is there are some things that are only true about what children had in their life back then, and some things that are only true about our lives now, our children's lives now. But in some ways, they can overlap. Yeah. Does this look more like this chart now? Mm-hmm. When things overlap or they're the same, for each thing, we say both of them share some characteristics or some things that are the same. So now you know these two big circles here are kind of coming together, and then what's in the middle is supposed to be true about both of them. Well, let's put some labels up here that will help us know this, all right? Let's say if something is true for children now, and it's just children now, it's going to go on the yellow side. This says children now. If something was only true for children back then, around the time of the first Thanksgiving, was it children now? And if it's true for both children now and children then, we're going to put it in the green part in the middle because we know it overlaps. It's true for both of them. All right. First, I'm going to get out some words. We're going to do the tough part first. This one says, they have electricity. Do you know what electricity is? Electricity is when you turn on a switch and you get a type of power that can make things go, electric power. Okay, do we have that now? We do. We can turn a light switch on and off and it gets powered up, right? Could they turn a light switch on back during the time of the pilgrims? No, they could not. That would not do anything for them. They didn't have light switches. So we're going to put these words by children now. Made up their own games. Well, children long ago made up their own games. Children now, what do? Yeah, they make up their own games. That's true for both children now and children then. I know when I was a kid, now that was in the past also, but we did a lot of making up our own games. And I was very lucky because where I lived, there were gazillions of children. Almost every single apartment, most of them, had kids living there. So we made up a lot of games together. We have live-in houses. That is tricky, isn't it? Because we might say, well, the Wampanoag children lived in wigwams, right? But yeah, the thing is, it was still their home or their shelter. Right? We live in houses now, too. Some people might live in trailer houses. Some people might live in brick houses. We might have some people who live in apartment houses. But we all have shelter. So we're thankful to say that's true about both. Oh, this is interesting. This was, let's see, how about, ride to school in cars. Could children long ago ride to school in cars? No, they could not because they didn't exist. So cars didn't exist, the children did. So we're going to put that in children now. That's only true for children now. I think this one is a very tricky one. Hunted for their own food. Well, we do know that children in days long ago hunted for their own food. Most children don't hunt for their own food now. Only some get to hunt for their own food now. So part of me wants to put it over here by children then, but I do think we still need to put it in both.
Yeah.
I actually got a picture from my brother of my niece's first deer this week. So some children do hunt for their own food. I'm kind of thankful that I can go to the grocery store and buy my own food.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, how about this? Built their own homes. Another tricky one. We definitely could say that people long ago built their own homes. Some of you may be in a family of builders.
Mm-hmm.
That's fairly rare. I think we're going to put built their own homes over here by children then, but we're going to still know that some people now build their own homes. Every now and then, you might know someone who got to build their own home. All right, how about this? This one says, live in America. Do we have children who live in America now? Yes, we do. Do we have children who live in America from way back before we lived here? There were children living in America too. So we can put it here under both. That's true for both of them. Uh-oh. I hope this one's true for both. It says, we're close. Yeah. Yeah. We're going to be very happy to put that by both. Because people long ago wore clothing. Maybe the clothing was different. But people also now wear clothing. Okay. This one says, have a cell phone. Okay. Do you have a cell phone?
No.
Maybe a couple of you. But if you were an old child, you might have a cell phone, or your parents might have a cell phone. Did the pilgrims have cell phones? No. No, they did not. That technology didn't exist yet. So we can only put that by children now. How about buy toys at the store? We can do that, can't we? I know with Christmas time coming, a lot of times kids are thinking about maybe picking up a toy here or there. But we can do that. Could the pilgrim children buy a toy at the store? They could not do that. They had to have toys made. Yep, or they had to make up what their toys were. Oh, I love this one. This says, love America. Do children now love America? I sure hope so. How about children long ago? Absolutely. Yeah, they were part of making America what it is. Yeah, and it took a lot of love. Okay. Oh, this is tricky. It says, wore dresses as babies. And a lot of times as babies, they call those gowns. Now, I know I used to really like gowns when my babies were newborns because it was easier to change their diapers. And really little babies had to do that a lot. But my babies only did that for the first few weeks they were born. Yeah, because it was a little bit hard to keep their legs warm, a little bit hard for them to move around, or if I wanted to put them in a car seat, it was hard to buckle. So it's very rare for all young babies now to wear a dress or a gown. It's possible. But back in the olden days when they didn't have to get babies in car seats, many of the babies wore gowns. I think this one belongs more over here. It's not that it is impossible to happen now, but it's not very likely. Okay, how about this one? Sailed on the Mayflower. Do some of you wish you could get a ride on the Mayflower? Maybe some of you adventurous kids do. But we really can't do that right now. Maybe we could be on a ship that was made to look like the Mayflower, but we don't get to go on the Mayflower. So I'm going to put this over here by only children back then. How about live in houses with floors? Now, all houses have to have some type of floors. But did you know way back in the olden days, they didn't have tile or carpet? Oh, they were dirt floors. So we couldn't many children back then had a floor built into their house. So we'd have to say that to the children now. And lots of things here. How about buying food at the store? Which one? Children now, children back then, or both? We have to say children now because they didn't have stores back in the times of the pilgrims. Alright, we've got a few more, but I'm going to leave these out because guess what I'm saying? I have some picture cards, and I thought we could fit the picture cards really good fast. What do you think? Shoes from children now or shoes from children back in the past? This is back in the past. We might get some stylish ones that try to look kind of retro or old. Or paper like this and a quill. Do we write in those in school? And not usually. We might try it out so that we could be like way back then. But this is how they would have written many, many years ago. Sometimes Mrs. Finkel feels a little bit lucky because she actually has one of those. It is like great grandma's. Yeah, it is tucked away. Okay, do you think this looks like a child from now or in the past? Yeah, this is now. Oh, it's pretty casual, right? Wearing some shorts, a t-shirt. Looks like a child from now. A different child probably would not have had shorts on. Oh, but could they have dressed like this? Yeah, with a bonnet, a long dress? Yeah, this likely to have happened in the past. Sometimes you like to dress up like that, or maybe you like to dress up like a pilgrim boy, especially celebrating Thanksgiving. Yes, but from day to day, that was back then. How about this baseball cap? I think it's Jackson's Spider-Man hat. Yeah, that's something from now. A cap is generally something children nowadays would wear. Like having a horse. Well, we know in the past they did. Do you think anybody has a horse nowadays? Some children do. Not only children who live near us have that opportunity, but there are children who live in more rural areas in the country. How about a gaming system? Do you think the pilgrims played on video games? They didn't. This stuff is something for children nowadays. What is bonnet? You might have one in your dress-up clothing. Sure. I know I have a big box of dress-up clothes, and I think there's a couple bonnets in there. But do we wear these on a normal basis from day to day? No, not really. That's a style from in the past. Oh, how about an oven? I'm a little bit jealous. I'm still waiting for my oven to come in. They didn't have one way in the past, did they? They had to cook over a fire. So I can't say in the past. I can't say both. I have to say we have this now. Oh, look at. Here's the one from the past. Yes? Oh, why do you want to put it in bow punching? Logan, you do too? Because you've gone camping and you've cooked over a fire? We have a good reason then. Okay, let's put it for both. Although we don't do that too often, we could do it. All right, how about this school car? Where do you think that one belongs? Yeah, that has to go for children now because they didn't have cars back then. All right, we could keep going here. Now we've got some long jeans here made out of jean material. Yeah, you could be wearing, I have Mrs. Finkel's wearing jeans today, isn't she? And these are shorter. They call these breeches. Yeah, the knickers. Let's put those for children back then, because even though we could get some to look old fashioned, we normally don't. Oh, look, we do have lots of sneaker stuff. Lots of shoes. Hey, children now. Alright, now this young lady has on kind of like knee-length dress, some bows in her hair. I also think it's meant to represent a child from nowadays. Okay. Cell phone? Most likely now. Not only most likely, but for sure because it didn't have them. How about this one? This is tricky. Yeah, This is a rag doll. Definitely in the past.
Oh,
a couple of you have a doll that looks like this?
Well, I guess you could have a doll that was made to look like an old-fashioned doll.
Not everyone has to be the latest and the greatest.
All right, so we'll put it in both.
I know my daughter Mary had a rag doll. She really liked it. It was one of her first dolls.
Well, boys and girls from studying these different things and comparing them and contrasting them, we found out that there are some things that are just true about children now, some things that were just true about children in the past, and some things that are true about both. What I like the best about the children from the past and now is, that they, where did it go? Wasn't there one that says about, love America, look at, I accidentally put it over here. I'm glad I double checked our work because we are hoping that children in the past and children now both love America and that they're thankful for all the wonderful things we have. Look at how many things we have. Clothing, one of our needs. Food is another need. Shelter. We are very blessed. So we're going to be thankful for all those things. Whether it's in the past, in the present, or in the future, it's always good to be thankful.